Hey everybody, welcome back to our neck of the woods. So today's Vlogmas day number 9. We need to go ahead and finally install our smoke detectors and carbon monoxide detectors that I've just been putting off for a while. Because obviously when you get them installed, you already start to cut down on its lifespan. I believe these have a 10 year or a 5 year. I'll have to look at that or tell you guys down below. But the other problem was the temperature. I wanted to get the attic insulation in because I don't think these things are really performance oriented if it gets like too hot or too cold. And in fact, it says here conditions can go from -4 up to 140 Fahrenheit. So I guess I should have looked at that before because it should be okay. But what we got here is carbon monoxide detectors and we've got smoke detectors. They do make a combo, but obviously that's more money. These just smoke detectors, unfortunately, they do not link to like other XSense devices. So I was a little confused on that. But now since I've bought these probably over a year ago, they've probably have new products out now where everything might be able to interlink. But again, we were really just trying to cut down on the cost of what we were paying. So carbon monoxides by themselves, they can be linked by themselves. And then these smoke detectors, they can just be linked to themselves only. And then I'm not sure what the remote tester will actually link to. The plan is to link them to the smoke alarms because the carbon monoxide detectors technically will be somewhat not that high in the house. So that way, if there is a leak, I can still reach up and kind of manually do them. But with the smoke alarms being up like on the vaulted ceilings, I'm not gonna be able to get up there easily and test it. So hence getting the test button that we can go ahead and test everything at once. All right, so unpackaging these guys, first thing that you notice is they are very, very small. They do come with mounting screws and drywall anchors. They don't hardly weigh a thing. Again, they are just super, super tiny versus what you're probably used to with an entire smoke detector that's probably more like this size. So you can just see just how much tinier they are. Now with these smoke alarms, you can link up to 24 of them together. So far, I've only bought 12 of these. I am gonna have to find out just code-wise to make sure where these actually have to go, or if we're just going above and beyond and putting more of these where they don't need to go, but it's a safety thing, just for our own well-being. They do come with their own replaceable battery. It is a CR123A, which is extremely common. It's got a pull tab to help you pull that battery out. And then there is a plastic sheet here that if you go ahead and remove that, obviously now once the battery's put back in, it will now be activated. All right, so you saw it light up there. So this one should be good to go. And its mounting plate is just a simple clockwise turn and it mounts there. And then the screws will go on the inside of the mounting plate there, just up into any drywall. So let's get all 12 of these out real quick. We'll pull all the plastic tabs, get them all activated, and then we'll interlink them all together. All right, all 12 of them are powered up now. And just FYI, these are the XS01-WR. These are the upgraded model. I don't know what the upgraded is versus the other ones, but they're the better of the pairs. So now that we've got them all powered up, first thing that we have to do is we have to interlink them all together. And the first thing is you can't link them all together at the exact same time. You have to do one to another, wait, and then one to another, and then one to another. You can't do them all at the exact same time. It takes up to 60 seconds for them to actually like interlink. It says it can take less than that, but it can also take up to 60 seconds before they're actually linked up. All right, so for the very first one, we wanna go ahead and press the test button. You wanna do that 4 times quickly. And then on your second device, you'll wanna press it twice quickly. And then I think both of the test light LEDs on the inside should go off, and that tells you that they're now linked to each other, and then we can again go and run down each one 2 at a time. But let's just see how easy or long this actually does take. So 1, 2, 3, 4. That beeped, and now it is searching. 1, 2. Well, that definitely took less than 60 seconds. That took what? 2, maybe less, 1.5. But apparently these are now linked together. Now, it doesn't say which one you need to stick with. Like, should you do the four button pushes on the first one and then keep going? Or should you like daisy chain on down? I'm gonna try to just keep as this one as my primary, but we'll set this one off to the side and we'll do that again. And then we'll try to do a test with all three to make sure that your primary goes through all of them. Or again, do we have to daisy chain down? So if we do four again, one, two, three, four. One, two. That's definitely taking longer than the first two. Still waiting. This may take a full 60 seconds then, I'm assuming. Come on. Maybe we do have the daisy chain on down instead. Well, those went off and I didn't hear any paired beeping. Oh, and in case you forget, there is a sticker on the side of these that say, do replace the device within 10 years after installation. So that tells you right there that you won't forget. All right, so we got these three devices. Apparently they're all interlinked together, but let's go ahead and do a test real quick. So before we get any further, we'll know if they actually are done. Although before we do a test, it does say that they both should have beeped if they were all interlinked. So I don't think that worked for some reason. But let's try that one more time just by holding down the first one. All right, that did work actually. These two did start going off. That took a second, but wow, that is loud. But again, we'll do it one more time. Hold down the primary. And there you go. All three of them are linked together, and only these three are linked together. None of the other nine went off there. So let's set these two off to the side. And now that we know that it works, let's go ahead and do that again, where we're gonna do one, two, three, four. It's searching. One, two. Wow, that's weird. That only took 2 seconds again. While that third one took up to 60 seconds max. But apparently we've got four of them now all interlinked together. So let's do it again. One, two, three, four. One, two. Now that's weird. I don't know why that third one took so dang long, but let's just go through these, get all 12 of these together, and then we'll go find out where we actually need to get them installed. All right, and last without forgetting, let's go ahead and test the test button. That again just had a pull tab that you take on out, and now the battery's connected. And then this last one again should be the same way. One, two, three, four, and then one, two. That 12th one, by the way, took just as long as number three to actually interlink, while all the other ones took only like 1 or 2 seconds. And then there was no beep afterwards. So I find that very weird. But this little guy's blinking. This little guy's blinking. And now let's see, are all 12 of these linked? I'm actually gonna go get some earplugs real quick. And then I think this guy works just like the smoke alarms. You just hold this down and then all 12 of these should be going off. But the second you release this, all of them will stop. So we do have to test this for a while by holding this button down because I need to make sure that each one of these is actually giving out its test beeps. All right. Success. So without even really being able to hear all of them easily, all of the test lights were going off all at the exact same time with pushing down the button. So we did it, we're done. So now let's go get them installed, pick out their good locations, and then one day we'll just set this off to the side. It does have a two-sided sticky pad to it, and this battery is replaceable in here. So maybe like on the inside of a kitchen cabinet or something, or inside of the pantry, we can just go ahead and stick this to the wall. And if we ever do need to do a test, you just go ahead and press that. And while all 12 of these won't be around to each other, we'll have to send Aaron into each room, or maybe I guess not use this as a sticky pad. And then we can just go around the house looking up at each one, holding it down and making sure that all of them are still going off together. All right, so first one I'm installing is out here in the garage. The reason why I'm not putting anything else out here in the garage, like a carbon monoxide detector, is obviously because we have vehicles and stuff. And we even have the diesel tractor, which the diesel tractor doesn't even have like a catalytic converter on it. So when that thing fires up, it does let out a plume of smoke. So with the carbon monoxide detector, I don't want that going off every single time. Hopefully that doesn't set off the smoke alarm, but there is a possibility that it will, because again, the diesel tractor is dirty. There's no catalytic converter, and it's just a possibility that it will happen. Maybe one day we'll be able to move it further over that way when we get that lumber out of the way. And even the exhaust pipe right now is facing me. If I face the exhaust pipe the opposite way, it'll let that smoke out that way and hopefully not trip this thing off, because that's gonna get annoying. But if it does, we'll have to store the Kubota out in the shed. Now, what I'm a little scared about though, is the fact that this wall is essentially soundproof. And because this entire wall is ICF, I need to make sure that I'm putting this smoke alarm kind of like right above my head, right by this doorway. Because the only way for us to get signal from out here into the inside of the house is hopefully the signal can transmit through a fire door that's steel on each side. And you know the signal's not gonna be able to go through the ICF. So hopefully this works. We'll only be able to find out if we hit the test button, and we'll be able to hear them on the inside and on the outside. But this is the best location that I can think for it, because again, we're dealing with some massive material here that basically wants to stop all signal. All right, one and done. 11 more to go. All right, so first two installed. I don't even have to look up the code because I just remembered what the county inspector actually said. We did just put one in the master closet in there, because the master closet does have electricity. That's where we're gonna be doing our ironing and stuff. So if a fire goes off in there, obviously I want one in there. We need to obviously put one inside of every bedroom, but I do remember him saying one needs to go outside of every single bedroom. So that means we're gonna have to have at least 12 in the house, but it just depends on spacing too. We may have to get one or two more. Like for example, is just one good enough for the entire kitchen? One good enough for the entire living room? And then like, is one good enough for the entire living area down in the basement? Because again, we just put one in the garage. We put one in the laundry room. We need to put one here in the kitchen. So that's 3, 4 for the living room, 5 for the bedroom, 6 for the closet, 7 outside of the bedroom, 8 and 9 in a bedroom, 10 and 11 outside of a bedroom, and then we only have one more to deal with. Yet we still have a utility room, the gym, the vault, and maybe another one down in the living space. So I think actually we're probably 3 short. We're gonna have to buy 3 more just to appease the county inspector, because I think he said again, they have to go like right on the outside of a bedroom door. So that is 3 basically then down inside of the living area, down inside of the basement, because you got 2 bedroom doors that they have to go outside of plus on the inside. And then that means that the basement really doesn't have any more smoke detectors, like over by where we're gonna put the bar and stuff. If the bar catches on fire, that's gonna take a long time for that smoke to get over to the bedrooms, as opposed to putting one just like right above the bar. So I'll have to think about that for a minute, but I think we are gonna be about two or three short, especially when we need one inside of the vault still. All right, everybody, quick recap. 12 of them went kind of fast. We got one out in the garage. We got one in the laundry room. Obviously, the dryer can be a fire source. I put one over here in the kitchen. I didn't really centralize it, and I got it kind of away from the oven. That way, if we're cooking something, that's not accidentally going off. Not to mention where like the toaster is gonna go or the microwave. I didn't want it directly overhead or anything, because in the RV, that actually is already a problem. Even though the smoke detector is away kind of from the oven and the toaster, it doesn't matter. That thing always accidentally goes off and it is such a pain in the butt. So kind of moved it away a little bit. And then I've got one in the center of the room here inside of the living room, all the way up there. Per the county inspector or the county electrician inspector, one right side, right outside of the bedroom. We got one inside of the middle of the bedroom. And then again, put one of there over there inside of the closet, because that's where the ironing and stuff's gonna happen. So all fire sources, all rooms are kind of controlled. The only thing up here, not really controlled, I guess, is the mud room. But inside of the mud room, it's literally only going to be a coat closet right in here. So there's not really a fire source that can happen in here. But if the inspector comes over and says, I need one more in here, because it does have like doorways where smoke inside of here will get like trapped, or smoke inside of here will get trapped and it can't get under these archways to get up here to get to that one, I guess that outlet could be a fire. So I guess we might have to do one inside of the mudroom. And then I didn't do either bathroom. So again, that's gonna have to be up to the inspector or you guys. Should I put a smoke detector inside of a half bath, or should I put a smoke detector inside of a master bath? And then down here, same thing. We put one right outside of the first bedroom, one of them inside of the bedroom, one of them inside of the bedroom, and one of them right outside of the second bedroom over here. So that is at least all code. But again, how I was saying, with this smoke detector being so close to the door and that one being so close to the door, there's no smoke detector anywhere in this living space down here. And we're gonna have a bar over here and the TV and entertainment center over there. So I am thinking, let's get one more for down in here, because we can put it somewhere up over here, because those are kind of a far distance away. And then again, I need another one for inside of the gym, because we're gonna have fans down in here and TVs and everything, and this will be a completely closed in room. That's gonna have a door that shuts. The utility room is gonna have a door that shuts. So this obviously needs a dedicated smoke detector. And then the last one that I actually had, we obviously put down in here with our fire suppression system, which is that ball right there. That thing will explode if it gets hot and melts that plastic sheet on the outside. And then there's basically like a fuse of like a firecracker. Once that fuse gets hot, it'll go in, hit an explosive charge, and this entire room will be exploded with like a white powder fire extinguisher substance. So we're kind of like double protected in here, and actually we're gonna be triple protected in here. Because now what we have to do is, I bought three carbon monoxide detectors. The three carbon monoxide detectors have to go wherever a possible carbon monoxide source is going to be. That is obviously going to be the utility room, because we're burning gas in there. I'm gonna head back up on the scaffolding one more time, and I'm gonna put a smoke detector kind of where one of those lights is, above the fireplace, because the fireplace is gonna be a gas fireplace. And then again, we're gonna put one in the kitchen, because the kitchen is gonna be a gas oven. So we've the three carbon monoxides will go anywhere a gas source will be in this house. And these are what these looks like. Again, kind of a traditional size of like a smoke alarm. Looks like this guy comes with three double A's instead of that CR. And these probably have a 10-year on them too. And then even though these ones do say X-Sense link, I'm not sure that these will actually link with the smoke alarms. And in fact, on the website for the smoke alarms, it says that it will only link to smoke alarms. So, but we'll might as well go ahead and give it a shot. But let's pop these batteries in here. This little mounting plate sits on there.
locks down in, and this will just get screwed to the ceiling, and then we'll get these installed. All right, and there is its startup procedure, because that LCD display there, hopefully that does go off, because that's gonna really kill that battery if that is always on, like 24/7. Hopefully that screen dies, and then again, this green power button just kind of flickers every once and again. All right, so install is the exact same to link these guys together. It's 4 quick pushes on the test button on one of them, and then 2 on another, and do 1 at a time. And it does say that these also only have a 10-year lifespan. But these things have been on for a good 3 or 4 minutes, and the LED screens are not going out. So that does not have me too confident that these batteries are gonna last too long, because that's obviously drawing a lot of power for that display to be on. But the power button is blinking every few minutes green that they are powered up and that they're actually working. I think all of these 3, even though they were in individual boxes, I think they came as a set and they were already connected together. So you have to go through a disconnect procedure because I was messing it up as I was like playing with them. So it's hitting one of the buttons 4 times and then holding it down for 1 more beep. And that tells you that it's been disconnected from the network. Now they're all working. I hit that one 4 times, that one 2, they paired right away. I hit that one 4 times again, hit that one 2, and they paired right away. So if we go ahead and hold any one of them down to test, hopefully all 3 go off. Right, so that definitely was a fault on mine. It was not a fault on the unit. I forgot that I must have bought those again as a triple pack, and they were already linked together. So I was like screwing them up, kind of like unpairing them. But we're good. So let's go ahead and get this one in the kitchen, one in the ceiling up above our head, then down in the utility room, and then we'll be done. All right, done up there in between the 2 lights for the fireplace. Done over here, kind of more towards the kitchen oven, so that way if there's a gas leak. And now I'm gonna use you guys as a guinea pig. I'm gonna set you guys up in the utility room, and I'm gonna test the one above the oven to make sure that it goes off, and then I'll recheck the footage to make sure that signal is actually transferring over there. The 2 in the living room should obviously transfer no problem, but I'm not gonna know about this one. So let me set you guys up in here to listen for this one, and then we will test the one out in the garage. I'll use the remote like over there by the vault, and I'll set you guys up out in the garage to see if that one actually goes off when we are testing it. All right, everybody, just went back and looked at the footage. It does work. It does take a second though, if you noticed out into the garage, you could hear through the door, the laundry room going off first, and it took a couple seconds for the inside of the garage to actually go off. So it probably does have a little bit of an issue with that signal. But again, fingers crossed, having that one out in the garage, if it goes off, we'll be alerted if we're sleeping in the master bedroom, where basically we have a soundproof wall. I bet if that garage went off by itself and not interlinked to any of these, we would not hear the garage one go off, because it's outside of that wall and it's on the outside of that kind of soundproof wall in there. So I'm glad that the signal does get through, but it does take kind of a second to actually do it, or so it seemed like on video. But that seems like a success. We just need to now purchase again 3 more. I need 1 inside of the gym, 1 inside of the vault, and I need 1 inside of the main living area a little bit further away from those bedrooms. So I'll purchase those at a later time and get them installed. But tonight was a success. I'm happy to finally have those installed. And hopefully if there ever is an issue in here, maybe we'll be able to heal it inside of the RV. Like if it goes out through the windows and doors here, maybe we'll be able to hear that around. If not, maybe we'll just go ahead and take one of them down inside of here, like maybe the one inside of the main living area down in the basement, and actually put one of those inside of the RV. So that way, if there's ever a fire or smoke inside of here, they'll communicate out to the garage one, and the garage one will communicate over to inside of the RV. So if the one inside of the RV is going off, we know we have a problem and we need to get in here ASAP. So again, I will wrap this up here, vlog day number 9, and we'll see you guys back tomorrow for vlog day number 10. Take care.